So hello everyone, so in this video I'm going to show you how to add sound to Unity. So we are going to play a sound when a button is clicked. So this works for both in laptop PC and both in Android mobiles. So let's get started. So first I'm having an empty Unity project. So I'm going to main camera and so just right clicking and go to UI. I'm just going to create an ordinary button. So we have a canvas and inside that we are having a button, and let me just change the size of the button. I'm just increasing the size, so it's okay. That's perfect. Now next what we are going to do is we need to just import the music that we are going to play when the button is clicked. So I have it over here. We're going to just drag and drop inside the assets folder. So this is going to be the music. So you can say it is in the form of audio source. So it's known as audio source in Unity. So this is that we want to have. So this music is going to play when we are going to press the button. So for that, you need to add a game object, create empty. So that's okay. So let's just rename it as music object. Music object. So that's fine. So now what we're going to do is, we're just going to drag and drop it on the music object over here. So now this music is going to be stored in, then corresponds to the music object. So if you just double click the music object, here we are going to see is audio clip music. So automatically a component audio source gets added to that music component object. So you can see, so here we can also adjust the volume, pitch, priority, and there are multiple other options you can just add it. So it's basically the audio sound, how it has to be. Starting sound, reducing sound, multiple effects you can add to your music over here. So let's leave that aside. So now what we're going to do is, we are going to create a CS script over here. So just we are going to that music event. So you can also add a CS script to the button, or you could add a CS script to your music object. Click the button and you are going to go to add component, and it's going to be a new script. Let's name it as MUS. Already exists, so just create MU. Create an add. So as you can see here, our MU, that's a music script, has been created, and I have opened it. So I opened it here. So it has a void start and void update. So we're just going to delete it. So it's not required in this thing. So now we are going to just drag and drop that game object, so that we are going to create a public audio source. That's it. So it's similar to creating a public rigid body like that, public transform, nearly similar to that. So just going to create public. It's going to be audio source. Audio source and audio clip are nearly similar. So it's okay. So it's just create a name, MUSIC1. So now we are going to create a function. So it's going to be public void play something, open it, and I'm going to just get music1.play. So there are multiple options. You can even play it on a loop or something like that. So there are multiple options to do when the button is clicked. So just going to save it. Now what I'm going to do is, you need to go to the loading on its loader. So now what I'm going to do is, here it shows music one in the button, we are in the button, and it's just none. So it's asking for us the audio source. So we're going to just drag and drop it over here. So we have successfully ordered the audio source over here. So now it's pretty much basic. So we just point out the function to it. So just go to this one and just drag and drop the button over here, and go to no function, and the function is going to be players. So that's it guys. So just now play the game. So you can see the game is button played, but whenever we hear the sound upright first, and then we press it. So okay, let me do it again. So if now we are going to play it, it will play automatically one time. And yes, you can say that. So actually the problem is that there would be option over here. For this you need to go to the music object And you need to take this one, play on awake. So you need to deselect this play on awake option. And if you now play it, we won't hear the sound on the time when it is played. See, you can't hear the sound. And when we press the sound, you can see it's played multiple numbers of subscribe. So that's it, guys. Thanks for watching and more such tutorials. Kindly subscribe and support. Thank you.